Another Trump ally is speaking out about the Russia investigation, but these remarks not intended to be made public. It's a secret recording of one of Donald Trump's biggest allies on Capitol Hill, Congressman Devin Nunes, at a closed-door fundraiser. And in the recording, first obtained by MSNBC, Nunes makes the case that it is their responsibility, Republicans, the Republicans in the House of Representatives, to act as the last line of defense to protect the President of the United States. Listen.
So therein lies, so it's like your classic catch-22 situation where, I mean, we're at a, this what puts us in such a tough spot. If Sessions won't unrecuse and Mueller won't clear the president, we're the only one, which is really the danger. That's why I keep, and thank you for saying that, by the way. I mean, we have to keep all these things. We have to keep the majority. If we do not keep the majority, all of this goes away.
Sinas Manaraju is in Washington with much more on this. Manu, as I listen to this, on one hand, not surprising to hear Devin Nunes make the case that he doesn't want the president to be impeached. But on the other hand, he seems to be saying it's Congress's job to protect the president rather than serve as a check on the executive branch, which is their job.
No question about it. And it's also Congress's job, in his view, House Republicans' job, to protect the president from the Mueller investigation, which is actually what the Democrats have been accusing Nunes of doing for the past year, ever since when he initially was running the Russia investigation. He came across what he viewed was something as controversial. He went to the White House, briefed the president about what he viewed as of concern in some intelligence reports, did not even brief his own committee. That prompted a lot of outrage from Democrats, his questions about how he handled some of the classified intelligence, forced him to temporarily step aside from running the Russia investigation. But outside, he continued to wield power. He squashed Democratic efforts to bring forward witnesses to the committee, to issue subpoenas and the like. And Kate, this essentially, these public private comments at this fundraiser feeding into the narrative that Democrats have been pushing for some time, that is all about Nunes protecting the president as he investigates the investigators, the FBI and the Justice Department, rather than what Russia did in 2016.
And Manu, there's much more in this as well, in this fundraiser that he talked about. He talks about it, almost seems to be acknowledging a strategy when it comes to possibly impeaching someone else, the man overseeing the Russia investigation, Rod Rosenstein.
Yeah, he raises some questions about the timing of impeaching Rod Rosenstein, suggesting that it's best to do this after the Senate were to confirm Brett Kavanaugh to be the Supreme Court, next Supreme Court justice, because of concerns that the process could tie up the Senate and imperil the efforts to confirm Kavanaugh before the midterms. Here's what Nunes said.
Yeah, well, it's a bit complicated, right? And I say that because you have to, So we only have so many months left, right? So if we actually vote to impeach, okay, what that does, that triggers the Senate that has to take it up. Well, then you have to decide what you want right now, because the Senate only has so much time. You want them to drop everything and not confirm the Supreme Court justice, the new Supreme Court justice. So that's part of why, I don't think you have, you're not getting from, like I've said publicly, Rosenstein deserves to be impeached. I mean, so I don't think you're going to get any argument from most of our colleagues. The question is the timing of it right before the election.
That's the Senate. So the Senate has to start.
The Senate would have to start. The Senate would have to drop everything they're doing and start with impeachment on Rosenstein. And then you take the risk of not getting Kavanaugh confirmed. So it's not a matter of the name of Sly Rosenstein. It's a matter of time.
Now, Kate, there are not the votes in the House to impeach Rod Rosenstein, and certainly not the votes in the Senate to convict him. But clearly, Nunes has been pushing this line for some time. And Kate, also, I've asked both the Speaker's office and also Kathy McMorris Rogers, who's the member of the House Republican leadership, who Nunes' fundraiser was attending that fundraiser, if they agreed with Nunes on these two points. I have not heard back yet, so we'll see if they align themselves with Nunes, particularly about whether or not they believe the House majority is necessary to protect Trump from Mueller. Kate.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, Kathy McMorris Rogers, you heard her right there on the tape with them. It'll be really interesting to hear what she has to say on that. Monty, great to see you. Thanks so much.